What's up mga kote? It's me Kuya Kyle and welcome to Quaternos. Wherein learning is the name of the game. At kung bago pa lang dito sa YouTube channel, don't forget to click the subscribe, like, and share buttons for more updates and videos. So, kamusta mga kote? So, we have here topic natin sa araw na to ay evaluating plays. So, ano nga ba yung evaluating plays and ano yung iba't ibang aspects niya? Ano yung meron sa kanya? And bago natin yun umpisahan, let's get into our trivia muna. So, did you know there's a precise speed where jogging becomes running? Calling all fitness nuts. According to conditioning coach Mike Antonidis, jogging means moving at speeds less than 6 mph. Any faster than that and you're running for the hills. So, ayun daw ang where is na ang jogging ay nagiging running if we exceed more than 6. So that's our trivia for today. So dito naman tayo sa ating agenda. So ang ating agenda is to evaluate different types of plays, importance of evaluating them, and of course to have fun. So evaluating plays. So ito muna, babasahin ko muna para sa inyo para mas maintindihan niyo yung evaluating play. So when you are writing an analysis of a play, remember that it may combine aspects of both prose and poetry. And the main distinction, of course, is that the play is meant to be performed for an audience. And an analysis essay breaks a play into parts, then discusses how the parts contribute to the whole effect or theme. In some cases, like for example, you may be asked to do research, or you may be analyzing just one aspect of a play, or comparing it to other works of literature. Analyzing a play will help you clarify what points you want to develop in your paper. So, habang nagsusulat do tayo ng analysis ng play, ang mga points na dapat nating tandaan is i-combine natin yung aspects sa ano. Yung i-combine natin yung mga aspects sa prose at saka poetry. And then yung analysis essay naman is we break it into parts and we discuss them kung paano sila nagko-contribute sa isa't isa at yung kung paano nagko-contribute yung team sa isa't isa or kung paano nagko-contribute yung bawat aspect sa team. Ganun. Next we have is overview. So yung overview, meron siyang 6 parts. Ang overview is when beginning, it's helpful to identify the play's key elements just to organize your thoughts. So, we have here 6. So, title and playwright, setting or time period, main characters or supporting characters, main conflict, resolution, and climax. So, sa title and playwright, so title, syempre yung title nung ano, nung essay natin or yung ginagawa natin sa or yung mga titles dun sa isang play, tapos yung setting niya kung saang lugar ba ginanap yung bawat scenario, yung time period kung may specific time ba, for example day or night, like for example 4:30 in the morning, ganto ganyan. And then yung main character, syempre yung mga bida dun sa play, tapos yung mga nagsusupport dun sa bida or kung sino yung hindi bida, ganon, kung sino yung ano kontrabida, like that. And yung main conflict, ano ba talaga yung parang dilemma, ano ba talaga yung problema. Tapos yung resolution, kung paano na solusyonan yung problema na yun, yung conflict na sinasabi. Tapos yung climax, yung nandito yung rising action, etc. And next you have is type of plays. So yung types of plays, a place can fall into one of several genres. It's like there are six or seven genres. We have comedy, tragedy, melodrama, and then romantic comedy, satirical comedy, and what do you call that? Tragic comedy yun. So, ayun yung mga types of plays. Tapos next naman is yung historical context. So considering the place historical context can be also helpful because many places make statement about the time in which they are written. So ayun, ay yung sa historical context. Next we have naman dito ay yung theme. Sa themes, themes yung topics and ideas na na-threaded throughout the play. So they are the ideas that threaded throughout the play and they are tied together. So identifying the common themes and where they overlap can produce interesting results. So ayun yung sa themes. Next we have is yung characters. So sa characters, characters act out of the author's themes and that are something manifestation of them. It's helpful to identify which theme a character represents. Next we have yung dramatic devices. So dramatic devices are strategies used by a playwright to add interest to the work, create a particular effect on the audience, or enhance the work's major themes. Some dramatic devices include the rising action, falling action, foreshadowing, a monologue, dramatic irony, narration, costumes, the flashbacks, the lighting, the musics, the foils, the chorus, what ano pa ba? Yung mga costume, yung time frame, break frame, yung soliloquy, yun, yung mga ganung bagay. Next naman is plot, setting, and organization. So, a play's general organization is controlled by a plot and setting. We need to consider whether the play is employed realistic or it's non-realistic. And does it present a surrealistic or metaphoric world, or does it attempt to depict reality? What is the dramatic effect on an audience of the setting, and also consider the significance of the events the author chooses to present versus the ones occurring off stage. And it is also important to consider the stage's appearance, yung mga element, and yung settings. Like if you're reading the play, you need to examine the stage notes at the beginning of each act. And next is the thesis. So once you have analyzed the play, write out the thesis sentence that takes place that explains some aspect of it. And next up is combine the ideas into the main claim on you want your paper to make, and you have to rephrase or omit some information as you streamline the thesis statement. And before you write, check your assignment for particulars and make sure that you develop the supporting paragraphs that you provide and support drawn from the text of the play itself. So what is the importance of evaluating plays? It provides valuable feedback on the design and implementation of the program. And the evaluation plays is a significant role in any educational program because it is an enormous role in teaching learning process, and it helps teachers and learners to improve teaching and learning. So thank you for listening. I hope na may natutunan kayo sa ating topic, which is evaluating plays. And again, this is Kuya Kyle and I'm signing out.